sometimes a sure thing is not the best thing. A hero is someone who does the right thing when the right thing isn't the easy thing to do. Matthew's education is not about obscure facts and little test scores. Education is about the overall effect of years of slow absorption, concepts, philosophies, approaches to problem solving. The whole process is so grand, all-encompassing, that it really can't be threatened by the occasional late-night no-hitter. You don't have to be blood to be family.
Hey, Mr. Feeny.
Something I can do for you, Mr. Matthews?
Yeah. Actually wanted to talk to you about summer school.
What about it?
You know the tests I've been taking where, you know, suddenly it looked like I was doing so much better and it was too good to be true?
Was it?
Okay. Okay, I feel better. Thanks.
Chair.
I cheated, Mr. Feeny. I had the answers to the test written on my hand.
And you only managed an A-?
I sneezed off a couple of the answers.
All right. Who gave you the answers?
Why would you have to know that?
Because two people are involved in this, and if I punish two instead of one, I get a bonus at the end of the week.
Guy in your class last year, he sold me the answers.
Why did you do this, Mr. Matthews?
I don't know. I really wanted to go to Europe this summer, and I guess I saw my old trip slipping away.
That's superficial, Mr. Matthews. Perhaps it's something a little deeper.
There is no deeper with me, Mr. Feeny. I'm not a good student. I'm just an average guy who can get by in a nice smile. I'm never gonna get an A. Never gonna make the honor roll. That's who I am. Might as well just accept it. I have.
The only thing that limits you, Mr. Matthews, is your laziness. I mean, you're just looking for an excuse to never get the grades that I know you're capable of getting.
I'm not capable. And they're just grades.
Just grades? Oh, it's just Europe. And they're just girls. And it's just a beach. Unless you happen to know that on that beach, in June of 1944, 150,000 troops landed and began the liberation of Europe. So that 50 years later, those girls could run around on that beach in freedom.
1944, that was Q. I put L.
Am I interrupting?
Thomas Hart, please, come in. In a way, this involves you.
It does?
Mr. Matthews just dropped by to confess that he has been cheating on his tests.
He has?
Yes. And since you've been tutoring him, I assumed...
Did he say I gave him the answers?
As a matter of fact, Mr. Matthews claimed that...
I can't believe you, Eric. I just tried to help you. How could you do this to me?
I didn't.
I think the question, Ms. Hart, is how could you do this to him?
I didn't think he could pass the test.
Oh? Why not? You see no potential in him as a student?
I just don't think he's the student type.
I see. And are you the teacher type? Or the type that just writes people off?
It doesn't mean that I didn't like you.
Well, you certainly don't respect him. Well, this is what I get for selecting a pretty girl to be a teaching assistant.
Excuse me?
Oh, you resent that? Because growing up with a pretty face, you had to work twice as hard to be taken seriously? I should think you, more than most, would want to help this young man have his chance of being taken seriously.
Are you firing me, Mr. Feeny?
Did you learn something today, Miss Hart?
Yes, sir, I did.
Well, then you can go.
So how come you didn't fire?
I don't write people off, Mr. Matthews.
You're a good teacher, Mr. Feeny.
Yes, and you're smarter than you look. Friendship, for example, is a real gift. And it's given with no expectation, and no gratitude is necessary. Not between real friends. Tate, your behavior, you will never grow as a person. But if you leave yourself open to experience, despite what others think, then you will learn and hold on to it and cherish it. Because there is nothing finer. And it may never come again. And that, my dears, is the most important thing that I could teach you. Sometimes the things you complain most about are the things that you care most about. Unfortunately, we don't always know that until it's too late.
Yo, in love with this Juliet, nothing's keeping him apart.
Mr. Matthews, brushing up on your Shakespeare?
Well, yeah, you know how you always told us that we should take what we learn in the classroom and apply it to everyday life?
You and Topanga?
She's moving to Padua.
Pittsburgh, she told me. I'm sorry, Mr. Matthews.
Well, listen, there are those who don't think we can make it because we're just a couple of kids, but, you know, here's the proof, Mr. Feeny, that two kids, with everything going against them, can take the power of love and make it work.
Whoa, boy.
What?
You haven't actually finished the play, have you?
Well, they're in love. What could possibly go wrong?
Flip ahead a little.
Yea, noise, then I'll be brief. Oh, happy dagger, this is thy sheath. There rust, and let me die. Happy dagger, see? Happy. She picks up Romeo's dagger, stabs herself, and dies. Shakespeare, what a hack.
You know, Corey, over the course of a person's life, he comes across a few defining moments. Now, this is one of yours. It's an opportunity, really.
Mr. Feeny, I don't know. I mean, look, Pittsburgh's 305 miles away. Maybe I'm just kidding myself.
Oh, well, for as long as I've known you, whenever you've been faced with adversity, you have always risen to the occasion. I have no reason to believe that you won't again.
Do you believe that two 16-year-olds can be in love, Friar Feeny?
I believe that you and Miss Lawrence have something that you won't allow yourselves to lose. And if you search your heart and listen to its instruction, you won't go wrong.
Thanks. That was brilliant. My true journey to Topanga begins, huh?
You see, it's not enough to leave school and just desire to succeed in this cold, cruel world. Because then you simply become a part of it. You must also have the desire to change it.
We live in a society where they tell us we have to look a certain way. So we're all under pressure to live up to unrealistic expectations.
Now our brave adventurers are climbing into the car as they sign the park waivers, which include an organ donation request.
Yeah, yeah, help yourself. What are you doing here?
I got a note.
From Corey?
From Feeny.
Corey, get out of that car. It's not safe. You'll kill yourself. Mr. Feeny, enjoy the ride.
George,
what are you doing? You surprised to see me in such a precarious position so far from the chess club, Mr. Turner?
George, riding a roller coaster is not the way to prove you're dangerous.
Would you care to join me, Mr. Turner?
No.
Corey, as your older brother, I am telling you to get out of this car now.
Oh, now you're so concerned for me? Now you stand up for me? Well, it's too late. I'm dead.
You're out of your mind.
Dangerously out of my mind.
Let's light this candle. Okay, I understand. You proved it to me. You're dangerous. You don't have to do this. Next time there's a double date, you're going.
I'm going?
You're going.
I'm going!
Screaming dive of death. And
up a piece of cake.
George. George. Weren't you in back when you left? Talk to me.
At one point, I was thrown forward out of the car. I had to run in front of the car.
George, I gotta tell you, I'm never gonna look at you the same way again. That took guts. And if you want the ski club, you got the ski club.
I can't believe you did all this because of me.
Yeah, I did do all this because of you, didn't I? Mm-hmm. Mr. Feeny, you probably did all this because of Mr. Turner.
Yes, Miss Matthews, I suppose that's all.
Look, Eric, would you do me a favor?
Anything you want, oh dangerous one.
I left my shirt there. Would you get it for me?
In the back?
Where? I don't see it.
Jonathan, help him find it for Pete's sake.
It's in the front.
It's not back here. I don't know where it would be.
Is it back under?
Okay, light that candle!
Entered the printing press, making the written word available to the masses. For the first time in history, the common man had access to the same information that used to be available only to the privileged few.
And who would you like me to make this out to, my darling?
Gentlemen, might I interrupt your press junket? There's some learning going on here.
Maybe you feel it's important to learn that Gutenberg invented the printing press, but pop culture and these pouty lips have made me a star.
I'm going to try to put this as kindly as possible. The show has turned into a circus, and you three are driving the tiny car.
Mr. Feeny, I'm proud that I knew that Krusty the Clown was the son of a rabbi.
Can I answer a real question, Mr. Feeny? About the Tigris and the Euphrates.
Miss Lawrence, I would never deny you your moment in the sun. But knowledge fever no longer has much to do with the kind of knowledge I would want you to absorb.
Mr. Feeny, look. Well, the show's proving that we're absorbing the right type of knowledge, right? I mean, that's why we're the champions.
Champions of what, Mr. Matthews? Of a generation whose verbal and mathematical skills have sunk so low, when you have the highest level of technology at your fingertips? Gutenberg's generation thirsted for a new book every 6 months. Your generation gets a new web page every 6 seconds. And how do you use this technology? To beat King Koopa and save the princess.
Excuse me, Mr. Undertaker, sir. It's my first time in a funeral home and I'm a little nervous. Could you please tell me what it is I'm supposed to do?
You're supposed to be in school, Mr. Matthews.
Mr. Feeny, you don't do that to a person. Especially in a place like this.
First time you've ever been in a place like this.
Yeah. You know, I didn't even know her. I mean, all I know is that she served us food. There's gotta be more to a person's life than that.
Oh, Corey, don't lightly dismiss something that meant the world to this woman.
Serving us food?
That's right. And she loved you kids. When anyone would ask her if she had children, she always said, I have 900.
And she didn't have any kids of her own?
Not everyone is that blessed. But she did have a place where she was cared about, a place where she knew she belonged. That blessing she recognized. I, for one, will miss her.
Yeah, well, our 900 kids are going to miss her, too.
Mr. Feeny, hey, I was in the library and I saw your light on. What are you still doing here?
Just packing up a few things. What on earth are you doing in the library?
I'm just working on my valedictorian speech.
Your speech would be fine. Give yourself a break.
Yeah, but now that I'm going to Yale, everyone's going to expect it to be like from someone who's going to Yale. Fine's not going to be enough.
Miss Lawrence, what did you actually come here to ask me?
I don't know what to do. Should I go to Yale?
If you're asking me if Yale is one of the finest academic institutions in the country, I would have to say, duh.
you're asking me whether or not you would be successful there, Yale wouldn't have accepted you if they didn't think you could live up to the challenge.
That's not why I'm asking.
I tell you what, I retire right now. What do you want?
If I knew what I wanted, I wouldn't have come to you.
Well, then listen very carefully. Unless you have a very good reason for not going to Yale, you should go.
Thanks, Mr. Feeny.
You're welcome. If you need any more counseling, my door is always open to my students.
Whichever one comes first. Although, you know, it'll probably be you because you're like, what, 80?